Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Understanding Phase Shift Keying. In this short presentation, we'll explain the technical fundamentals and main variants of phase shift keying. Purely analog phase modulation is rarely used for communications. Phase shift keying, or PSK, is a digital modulation scheme in which we shift the carrier between different phases. Information is conveyed by changes in the phase, not by the absolute phase of the received signal. For example, a logical 1 could be indicated by changing the phase, and a logical 0 could be indicated by no change in phase. In pure PSK, both the amplitude and the frequency of the transmitted carrier are normally kept constant, although many modern digital modulation schemes, such as QAM or APSK, combine both phase and amplitude modulation. The most basic form of phase shift keying is called binary phase shift keying, or BPSK. This is also sometimes called 2PSK, or more rarely, phase reversal keying. As mentioned earlier, we indicate a transition in bit values by changing the phase. Here, a simple 180-degree reversal in the phase of the carrier signal. And because we have only two states, the symbol rate of BPSK is the same as the bit rate. Rather than look at phase changes over time, as we did on the previous slide, constellation diagrams are often used to represent signals that have phase changes. In constellation diagrams, phase is represented by an angle, and amplitude is represented by a distance from the origin. Since PSK signals normally have constant amplitude, all of the points will lie on one circle. For example, in BPSK, there are two phase states, 0 and 180 degrees, and therefore these would be shown the same distance from the origin, but on opposite sides of the circle. Transitions between states are shown as lines connecting the points. Note, however, that in practice, these lines are usually not completely straight. Like most other forms of digital modulation, we can increase throughput in PSK by increasing the number of states. For example, QPSK, also called 4PSK, has four states, each separated by 90 degrees. Four states means that each symbol is 2 bits, so our bit rate is twice the symbol rate. Note that the mapping of phase states to bits is flexible. For example, there's no reason why we couldn't have this mapping of states to bits. The only requirement is that the transmitter and receiver both agree as to which bits are represented by which states. Like BPSK, QPSK is used in a wide variety of digital data communication standards, such as various cellular standards, different Wi-Fi or 802.11 variants, cable television, satellite, etc. We can further increase throughput by increasing the number of states. For example, 8PSK has 8 possible states, and this in turn means that we can send 3 bits per symbol. Orders higher than 8PSK, such as 16PSK or 32PSK, are possible, but they're much less common in practice, primarily because the error rate becomes unacceptably high. The closer the states or the points are together, the harder it is to generate or receive the symbols correctly. If higher data rates are needed, this is usually accomplished by using more complex modulation schemes, such as QAM or APSK, that combine both phase and amplitude modulation. Another issue in phase shift keying involves avoiding the origin, that is the center or zero point in our constellation diagram. Let's use QPSK as an example. When we transition from the 1-1 state to the 0-1 state, we don't pass through or near the origin. On the other hand, transitioning between the 1-1 and the 0-0 state does cause a signal to pass near the origin. Transitioning through or near the origin can be problematic, primarily because the carrier amplitude temporarily goes very low, or to zero. One undesired result of this is a high peak-to-average power, which in turn complicates the selection or design of transmitters and amplifiers. Passing through or near the origin can create a number of other problems, such as synchronization issues, or it can increase the spectral occupancy of a signal. However, there are two variants of PSK that are designed to avoid the origin. These are offset PSK and differential PSK. In normal QPSK, the transition from the 1-1 state to the 0-0 state would involve moving through or near the origin. In offset PSK, we avoid the origin by delaying one component of our symbol by half a symbol duration, that is, never moving more than 90 degrees at a time. For example, In the first half symbol time, we transition between these two states, and then in the second half symbol time, we transition the rest of the way. Note that by doing this, we avoided going through or near the origin, but still ended up at the same location at the next symbol time. Comparing these two modulation schemes side by side, with QPSK on the left and offset QPSK on the right, we can clearly see how offset QPSK avoids passing through or near the origin. The second method for avoiding the origin is differential PSK, or DPSK. In differential QPSK, we use two constellations, offset by a given amount, in this case, pi over 4 radians, or 45 degrees. D-QPSK forces a phase transition, or phase change, at every symbol time, regardless of the bitstream, and transitions must occur from one constellation to another, here between the blue and the orange constellations. Because of these conditions, no transition between blue and orange states will ever pass through the origin. Another way of looking at this is to say that the maximum phase jump in DQPSK is 135 degrees. It's important to keep in mind that even though the DQPSK constellation would appear to have 8 states, only 4 targets are possible at any given time, so the throughput or bit rate of DQPSK is the same as normal QPSK. Comparing actual constellation diagrams, we can clearly see how the use of differential phase shift keying also avoids transitions through or near the origin. There are a number of applications that use offset and differential PSK. Offset QPSK is most often found in satellite systems due to its spectral efficiency and constant power envelope, although it's often used for other types of data transmission and broadcasting. A special variant of offset QPSK, called shaped offset QPSK, or SO-QPSK, is used in many telemetry applications. A well-known application of differential PSK is Bluetooth, and DPSK is also used in some RFID applications as well. Let's summarize what we've covered. Unlike amplitude or frequency modulation, phase modulation is almost exclusively used for digital data, whereby changes in the phase of the carrier indicate different states or bits. So-called constellation diagrams are often used to visualize the different states in PSK and/or the transition between these states. Both BPSK and QPSK are fairly common, and even 8PSK is used in everyday applications. But generally speaking, modulation orders greater than 8PSK are uncommon in practice. Depending on the modulating bit pattern, it's possible for a standard PSK signal to move through or near the origin, and this is usually undesirable for many reasons. Two special variants of PSK can be used to avoid these transitions through the origin. These are offset PSK and differential PSK. This concludes our presentation, Understanding Phase Shift Keying. If you'd like to learn more about digital modulation or test the measurement solutions for digitally modulated signals, please see the links in the video description. Thanks for watching.